Hey guys, welcome back to Naughty Threats. Just in case you're here on my channel for the first time, do subscribe and also hit the bell icon so that you don't miss on our future videos. So recently I got this kind of blouse stitched for myself with these kind of cut work in the back neck. This is a boat neck blouse. It's just in single color. I have kept it single color so that I can pair this blouse with many saris. If I wanted to pair it with a contrast sari, I can do that, as well as any sari that has pink, I can just pair this blouse. So that is the reason I've just got stitched with self color piping, and just everything else is in pink. There's no other color. So this is the neck. It is a front open blouse. So this is how I've got it stitched. It's a princess cut blouse. And for the sleeve, I have got this kind of pattern. So what I will do is, in today's video, I will show how to actually add a bead here to give it a little trendy look. Or you can also just hand stitch it or just attach one small dory. But I wanted to stitch bead, matte finish bead. So that is the reason I thought I'll share it with you guys. So sleeve is like this. Once the bead is stitched, this will actually get closer and it'll look really nice when you actually wear it. So as of now, that's the plan, and I'm also thinking of adding some knots here on the neckline because it's looking too plain. So I have not yet decided yet. I think I will be adding some French knots using this kind of zari thread. This comes in a roll like this. It's I think like embroidery floss. This has around let me count. I myself am using this for the first time, so I'm not really sure. So this has many strands actually. Very thin strands are together rolled. So around 12 strands of zari. So there is no hassle of making 12 strands using our single strand spool. So I thought I'll just give it a try. And moreover, this is gold. So all the silk saris have gold. So I thought it will be a nice try. So let's see, first we'll add beads and then I'll show you how to add some French knots. I have already added beads for the first sleeve. So here in this gap, I've added just one bead and I have stitched both the ends together so that it doesn't fall apart. So the same thing I've done here, and over here, since it was looking plain, I've just added three beads, and these are matte finish beads. So we generally use these kind of beads in ari work. So that is what I'm using here. So we'll see how I did this on the other sleeve. So first of all, I've taken four strands of cotton thread in the sewing needle. I've knotted my thread already, and here I will be piercing in the center. There is this shape here, so I will be getting the needle out from the center. It's very important to match the center of this shape to the center of the other side. And then I'm going to just make one knot here, like this. And then I will add one bead to the needle. And then I will pierce the needle to the center of the opposite side, like this. So what happens is the bead will sit like this, as in the side of the holes of this bead is facing the sides, like this. Pull it tight and go one more round like this. So this side, I have come from wrong side to the right side. So I will be going into the bead one more time, just to make sure it is secure. Pull it tight because we don't want any loose thread. And then I will go back and knot it. This is how simple it is to stitch this bead. So pull it tight before you knot. So knot is very simple, like how you knot after stitching the shirt button. Same way, you will just pick up a little bit of fabric, wind the thread and knot it. So I've knotted twice and I'm going to trim off the extra thread. So I'll do the exact same thing in the next part here. Once that is done, then this step is completely optional. If you want, you can add three beads here. If you don't want, you can simply skip. So I'll show you guys how I did that. So if this is the center, I'm getting the needle out from here. This is my center point here. Because even here, I want the bead to sit sideways. And then I'll add one bead and then go back here. Same way, I will come from this side. Add the next bead. And then go back in the same hole so that the beads are close. So here I have two beads. So in between those two beads, I will add my third bead. So tighten it and then knot it the same way like you knotted the previous one. So this is a very nice and easy idea to just add some beads or pearls in your old blouses. If you have any plain blouses which you might have stopped wearing because it is plain, you can just follow these simple steps and add some beads and bring it to use. So I will finish this and then I will show you guys how to make the French knots around the neck. So both my sleeves are done. I've added bead on both the sides and I've already started working some knots on the neckline here. I have inserted all the strands in the needle and I have doubled it and I have knotted. So here in the needle I have like two strands. I wanted the knots to be thick because apart from this I don't think I'll be doing anything else in the neck. So I wanted these to be slightly thick and I'm doing it at this distance. The thread is just running from one knot to the other knot like this. Since there is piping, it is actually hiding the thread. The thread is not visible on the right side. So how I actually do this is, I don't know if I should be calling this as a French knot because it's not really a French knot. It is somewhat like a bullion stitch. So once I come out here from the same point, I just pierce like this. And then I'm going to wrap this, the thread that is coming out of the fabric, not this thread, but this thread. Wrap it around the needle like three times, like we do for bullion knot, and then pull the needle out. It's a little difficult to get the needle out because the eye of this needle is slightly thick and moreover, it is around the neck. So the piping fabric and the lining plus the main fabric, it has to pass through all the layers of fabric and come out. So it's a little tricky. But once it is out of the fabric, it is easy. So just pull it like this. Make sure the zari doesn't roll. So once we have pulled it, it looks something like this. So this is how it looks right now. So what I did was, I just went back in the same place where I started. So the knot kind of bent towards me. So it looks more like a bullion knot to me, honestly speaking, but yeah, it is looking nice. So I thought I'll just continue working the same, just around the back neck. So again, at a little distance, I take the needle. Pull it tight and then repeat the same process. Since I wanted the knots to be slightly bigger, I am winding the thread around the needle three times. If you want it to be slightly small, then you can just do it two times. I finished working on the neckline and this is how it is looking. Kinda looks nice and natural. That is the reason I've just left it like that. Now for these, I'm not going to fiddle around too much. In case you want, you can just hang some tassel or bead hangings here. But I am not too much of a bead person. So that is the reason I'm just leaving it like that. So the sleeve is also done. I'll try to add a pic of my hand with the sleeve so you guys can check it out. So I guess that's all in today's video. In case you feel this video was helpful for you guys, do give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Keep sharing our videos with your friends. And of late I have been updating my blog often. So do check it out. Under RE work, there are some embroidery tracings that I am uploading. It's very easy for you guys to just download the image and use it just in case you're doing RE work on blouses. So I will be updating the blog very frequently from now on. So do give it a look every now and then. I'm sure you will find something useful. And apart from that, if you have not subscribed to my vlog channel, Kanika Reddy Vlogs, do subscribe now. And I shall see you guys with more interesting stuff. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.